Hello. Today we're going to show you a spinefish fin route that I use quite a bit, especially on an Ironman challenge where I need a lot of the motes and the spinefish themselves. This is a perfect run. It's rarely used, and the respawn rate is anywhere from 17 to 25 minutes, so every half hour it's easy to go to, and I'll show you where it's located. Here we go. And the idea is you want to use these for the infused corruption tinctures. And they remove the corruption, and they give you the maximum resistance for, I believe, 5 minutes. And it just takes a spinefish and a river crest and a water to make those. And I think it's a 150 on your skill. Also, I adjusted the mic, so my voice should be a little clearer, and it shouldn't miss the first syllable of words. It was missing that. It didn't sound right before, and I hope that fixed it. So, where you go? We're in Eden Grove. Gatherer's Road. Right here is the Genesis Shrine. And what we're going to do is we port here, and we're going to end up running straight down to here. Now, there's 19 spinefish on this route. Normally, I only do the first set of about 9, and then I take the shrine to my next location that I want to go to. And here it is. Give you the whole route then. And, again, I'm on the PTR, not because, there's a lot of competition for this, which there really isn't. Even on a busy, busy server, there's just not competition for this run. I just run right by these guys. They're level 58, but you can run by them. And there's an interesting star metal right over here. And if you bring along that fencing sword instead, you can actually use it to get across the rivers a lot faster. Right here we have iron ore. There's 3 of them. They're almost always up. And then star metal, which is really nice to get. So all we did to open it up is run right from here across and out to this. You can even see the shrine right across the little stream here. I run right across. I grab these 3 iron. I grab the 2 star metal nodes, which are useful, especially in Iron Man. I needed all this, and I still do. I drop down on this, and it's always fun to grab this. And we're going to drop down this waterfall anyways. So here we go. Not a problem. The only thing you have to worry about are those boars. And maybe some alligators. Right away we got 1. And all we did was drop right down. So we stay on the right hand side. Look down here, and here's the second one, and I got water motes. Seems to be like a 50-50 shot. You might get water motes, and you might get spinefish. That's the 4th one. Got water motes. Sometimes you need water motes, sometimes you need spinefish. See if we aggro those guys. We didn't. And now we did. Looking at me. And the greatsword is just a lot of fun. At this point, we've jumped down, we've grabbed those, and we come to this bridge. And normally I just run around this side, jump up, and right here as I'm crossing the bridge, just jump right over, hop over this, and here's the next one. And then I believe the rest are going to be right here. And this is the Genesis Shrine. Don't know why that's hard to pronounce. And usually I run across right here because there's not the water's not technically deep enough to slow you down. And sometimes they're hard to target. And they'll show up like that on the map. Hop over that. And there we go. See if we can pick it up. There should be one more. And at this point, you have a decision to make. You can just bail out. That was a quick run. It looks like we got 4 and 140 motes, which isn't bad at all. And we picked up this. So we've got these and these. And that was a really, really fast run. With I think we fought one creature. Top over here, grab this. You can even ignore these guys. Run right over here, grab the star metal, the iron, grab the air, drop down, grab it. You'll get very used to which side to be on. Doesn't take much at all. Now this is where it gets a little trickier. There's one here. And then across this, there's going to be 4 more right along here. Right here, there's going to be 1, 2, 3, and 4. We could go with those, or we can go to this one, and then we drop down to here, and we grab them this way. Normally, I just bail out and run over here, but we can go take a look. This is part of the route that I don't normally take, and I don't think a lot of people take it either, because it's you don't want to ever have to backtrack. But if you really need these spinefish, and you don't mind taking a little bit longer, or if those first ones were already taken, there's the next one right there. Not a problem at all. And then it's on the tip of this island, right about here. We're going to run to that one next. Keep that open. We're just going right over here. There's a bunch of these along the way as well. And this is where you could use the fencing sword to jump across. If you use your map, it'll actually highlight it for you. And it's always nice to pick up fresh water when you don't want to. Gonna jump out of that. The next one is gonna be right here, and then here, and here. So let's run that way. Looks like there's an alligator on our HUD somewhere over there. There he is. And let's see if he wants to mess with us. He does not. We're going to go, we'll just mess with these guys real quick. And this guy as well. Ranged character is always fun to mess with, or not mess with. And if you look on your map, it'll show up in purple. And the neat thing is, if you're logged on for a while, these should stay there too. The next one, I'll put a pin in it just to make it easy. And then we can just follow that over there. I don't do this side of the run very often, but it's nice. Just that I just don't need that many of these. But if you want to get them to make them and sell the sell the potions. You could do that. You could do the tinctures. You could actually sell the raw materials. I'm doing the Iron Man challenge, so I don't use any of the training posts. That's what's kind of forced my hand to actually do these in the first place. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a pin right there. And we're going to ignore all these guys. We're just going to sprint. Try to sprint. Let's see if I can actually sprint. Oh, my keybind is broken. I have a keybind on my mouse that allows me to sprint. Now I have to hold this down. But we can just ignore these. And I'll put a timestamp down below if you want to skip ahead to the next part of the route. I'll label it first part, second part, third part. Okay. The next one, I'll put a pin in right there, I believe it. It's right around there. Some bigger creatures over there. And this is right where the old boar hunting spot was. All in here where the boars are for the topaz potion. A lot of people use that spot, but now it's easier to use, easier to go out in brimstone sands and do it there. Let's see if we can get rid of these guys so I can show you the next location. Both just kind of died up. Kind of see it already. And it's right here. We'll just run over to it. And again, if you're running along the water like that, you can kind of just use your mini map. And there might be one. Oh, we got a blight moth. I forgot about that. The next one is going to be on this island right there, and then right here. So let's go do that. These are really close together, and if you have a good memory with this, the next one is going to be on the other side of this building right down here. So it's very simple. I'll try to leave the maps on longer, so if you have this video on a second monitor, you can kind of just follow along. Should be some monsters around there somewhere. And last but not least, right here. But this is the reason why I kind of give up after that first step. I don't like backtracking, and I really like it that I can just go from one shrine to the Genesis shrine and not have to worry about anything. It's just shrine, grab all the stuff, grab half of these, and use the shrine to port to the next one. So, in conclusion, there's 19 spinefish on this route. The first section, second, and third in total. We ended up getting 310 water motes, the blight moth, 8 spinefish, not bad at all. So that's going to give you 8 of these, no problem. The river crest is super cheap. You can find it or buy it. And then you're going to end up with 8 of these. That's not bad at all to have 8 of those on hand. And if you do this run a few times, you'll end up with 24, 32, and you can go from there. And we'll just take a quick look. I'll even put one of these on. Let's see. There it is. And my corruption of resistance. Let's see if it will tell us. It doesn't tell you the exact number. I'd have to go find some corruption. And we're in good shape. And I'll take one last look at the map And I hope the my voice is more clear this time. If it is or if it isn't, let me know. So it starts here. You run over here, grab that, grab the three iron, grab the star metal, drop down, grab one, drop down, grab these, hop over the little bridge, jump over, grab the next one, and right here is where you're going to make your choice. You can go down and grab these. Then there's four more. You can see this on the map still. And then you'll run over here, 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 there, and there. I just like it that I can instead run through here, jump down, get all these, get half of them, use the shrine, go to another place, like the other video that I did with the Orichalcum, where I can just port over to the Lover's Shrine, drop down, and grab six Orichalcum nodes, veins, and go from there. But anyways, thanks guys, I just wanted to let you know, and that's how I do it for the Iron Man challenge, where if I need certain things, that's how I get them quickly. Enjoy!